Understood.
Clear. En route.
Just lead the way.
Thank you.
over there.
Before, machine cultists. The survey team must have unearthed some alien technology that turned them into mindless fanatics.
Whatever they found, it is long gone now.
That's it. Bag 'em and tag 'em.
This place looks abandoned.
According to these data logs, the survey team unearthed some kind of alien technology.
Ready.
Saddle up!
Thank you.
Thank you. Intruders! Kill the hostage!
We need to hurry! They're gonna kill us!
Yeah. See how it is? You write letters and everyone ignores you. Force is the only thing people appreciate. So how about if I kill Chairman Burns and finish the charade?
Please, I was trying to help you people.
Let's not do anything we're all gonna regret.
Why not? What have we got to lose? Since the chairman here decided that we didn't get reparations, we've got nothing left to live for.
But I've changed my mind. Seeing you all, it's clear that you all deserve...
You had your chance. Some L2s are nearly crippled from side effects of the implants, but you voted against reparations.
Think about this. Burns is the one man who can help you.
Yes, if you release me, I can take another look at the reparations request.
What? We're supposed to trust you? Sure, you promise us freedom and say everything will be fine, but as soon as we surrender, you'll double-cross us.
I'm not promising to let you go. All I'm saying is that Burns will take another look. Right, Burns?
Absolutely. I had no idea that the L2 biotics were this desperate. If I'd known, the reparations will come. For whatever it's worth, I promise that.
You're right. I don't want to die. Maybe something will happen this time. We surrender.
Thank you, Commander. I thought I was dead when they took me. I'll see to it that the reparations discussion is reopened. I didn't know they were so desperate.
A Fifth Fleet cruiser will be by shortly to pick you and the prisoners up.
Thank you, Commander. I thought I was dead when they took me.
Message coming in. Patching it through.
Thank you for dealing with the hostage situation, Commander. Chairman Burns was quite impressed by the way you resolved the situation peacefully. Your assistance above and beyond the formal duties has been noted, Commander. Fifth Fleet out.
Thank you. I will destroy you!
All targets down.
moving out.
Commander, good to see you.
You've been with CSEC a while. Have you seen much action?
Well, not as much as you, but yeah, I've seen some interesting things.
I bet you have. Anything in particular that stands out?
I remember this Solarian geneticist I was sent to investigate. That case was a bit disturbing.
What happened? Why were you investigating him?
I was tasked with tracking black market trade on the Citadel. Most of it harmless, nothing I needed to pursue. But during the course of my investigation, I noticed an increase in the trade of body parts, organs mostly. We usually get a few of those, but not the numbers I was seeing. We weren't sure if there was a new black market lab or if some freak was harvesting organs from citizens.
You've seen this before on the Citadel?
Every so often, some lab sells unwanted parts through the black market. They're not as bad as the psychos. I remember this one Elcor diplomat we caught in my first year on the job. He was hacking people up and selling their organs. Had the station in a bit of a panic. But this case wasn't that clear-cut. Turns out there was more going on than we first realized.
So how did you figure out what was happening?
First, we got a hold of a sample and ran DNA tests. The weird thing was, the match led us to a Turian who was still alive and was very convinced he'd never lost his liver. After a bit of digging, I discovered this Turian worked briefly for Dr. Salion, the geneticist. So I went to his lab hoping to find evidence of cloned organ development. But there was nothing. No Salarian hearts, no Turian livers, not one Krogan testicle.
You're kidding, right? Why would anyone want Krogan testicles?
Some Krogan believe that testicle transplants can increase their virility, counteract the effects of the genophage. It doesn't work, but that doesn't stop them from buying. They'll pay up to 10,000 credits each. That's 40,000 for a full set. Somebody's making a killing out there.
What'd you do about the geneticist?
I brought in some of his employees for interrogation, to see if I could get them to talk. While I was interviewing one of them, I came across something suspicious.
You mean threatening? Was that really necessary?
Maybe, maybe not. Either way, it paid off. One of my detainees started bleeding profusely during the interview. We offered to patch him up, and he got frantic, freaked out. I ordered a full exam to find out what was going on. Our medics found incisions all over his body, some of them fresh. That was our big break. These people weren't just Dr. Salion's employees. They were test tubes. Walking, living test tubes.
He was growing parts inside these people?
Exactly. He cloned their organs right inside their own bodies. Then he harvested them and sold them off. Most of the victims were poor. He'd pay them each a small percentage of the sales, but only if the organs were good. Sometimes an organ wouldn't grow properly. So he'd just leave it in them. Most of them were a mess, but only on the inside, hidden so nobody could see it.
I hope he got what he deserved.
That's the worst part. We never caught him.
Why not? What the hell happened?
He ran, blew his lab, grabbed some of his employees, and headed for the nearest space dock. By the time I found out, his ship was already leaving. He threatened to kill his hostages if we tried to stop him.
But you went after him anyway, right?
I ordered Citadel Defense to shoot him down, but CSEC headquarters countermanded my order. They were worried about the hostages, worried about civilian casualties if the ship was destroyed so close to the Citadel. I told them those hostages were dead anyway. It just used them to make more organs. But they wouldn't listen.
It's not worth the risk. You pursue the vessel and disable it. That's the best choice.
They sent the military after him, but he got away just the same. Yes, they did. I went to Palin and told him what I thought of him and his policies. He said if I didn't like it, I could quit. Well, I almost did. All they had to do was disable that ship, stop him from running. Maybe the hostages die, maybe they don't, but at least we stopped the bastard responsible for it all.
If you don't care about the fate of those hostages, then you're no better than he is. You're just a terrorist with a badge.
Yeah, maybe you're right. It doesn't make it any easier, but I see your point. Just wish I could have stopped him. That's all.
Do you have any idea what happened to Dr. Salian?
I sent out feelers from time to time, hoping to find something. I thought I'd found him a while back. He changed ships and changed his name to Dr. Hart, his idea of a joke, I guess. I told the military, but they weren't convinced it was him. I got the transponder frequency for his new ship, but I just can't get anyone to check it out.
I'll check out the coordinates when I get a chance.
I was hoping you'd say that, but Commander, take me with you when you go. If it's Salian, I'm gonna be there when you find him.
What do you want, Shepard?
Why did you become a mercenary?
Lots of reasons.
Such as?
Such as, I needed to get out of our system. I needed to eat. I needed to survive.
Why not stay and help your people?
I tried to help. That's why I had to leave.
What happened?
I was betrayed. I was head of a small tribe. We were trying to restore order after the war, but the other tribes were against us. They followed Jared, one of the few warlords who survived the war with the Turians. But he was old, and so were his ideas. He wanted to continue the war. He wanted us to fight. Turians, Salarians, each other. It didn't matter who, as long as we were fighting.
What did you want?
I just wanted Jared to shut up. To stop his ranting. I wanted him to stop leading the tribes astray. But he couldn't understand how much things had changed. We didn't have the numbers to go to war. Even if we did, the Genophage made sure we couldn't replenish our numbers fast enough. I told them all to forget about war. We needed to focus on breeding, at least for one generation. And for a while, we were getting through. Some of the tribes started coming around.
I take it the warlord didn't appreciate that.
No, he didn't. He arranged a crush with the tribes, a meeting on neutral ground. He wanted to talk. We met at the Hollows, near the graves of our ancestors. The skulls of our dead laid bare to remind us where we come from, and where we all go. It's as sacred as any Krogan place can be. Violence is forbidden.
Sounds like a trap to me. You must have suspected as much.
I did. But when your father invites you to a crush, well, there are some laws that even we hold sacred.
Jared was your father?
He was. Until that day. We talked, but we didn't get anywhere. When it was clear that I wouldn't join him, he gave the signal. His men leapt from the graves of our ancestors like Krogan undead. The few that were loyal to me died quickly. I escaped with my life, but not before I sank my dagger deep into my father's chest. That is why I left, and that's why I'll never go back.
You must have family other than your father. Don't you miss them?
You're trying to make me cry, Shepard. I've got some unfinished business with my family, but that's all.
What kind of business?
Before I left, I made an oath to my father's father. I swore to recover my family's battle armor. It was taken from him after the uprising.
What's so important about this armor?
It's a relic. Useless, really. But it was worn by 5 generations of my family before the war. It's rightfully mine. Originally, it was taken by the Turian military. We weren't allowed armor or weapons after the war. Now, it's in the hands of Ton Actus, a Turian scum who collects relics from the war. He's made millions selling Krogan artifacts that were stolen from my people. He's got several bases where he stores his goods, all fortified and guarded. I just don't know which base has my family's armor.
Just tell me where to start looking.
I'll upload the data to your nav system. But Commander, I want to be there when you find him.
So long, Rex.
Shepard.
Shepard, I need to talk to you. It's important.
Is something wrong?
You know the data you took from those Geth control nodes? The information you uploaded to Alliance Control? I want a copy of it.
You want to bring this data back to the Migrant Fleet?
Those files have information that could be vital to our efforts to understand the Geth. It could be the key to helping us reclaim our homeworld.
If I give you this data, your pilgrimage is over. You'll go back to your own people.
Not right away. I'll stay with you as long as it takes to stop Saren. But my people need this.
You think you can use this information to destroy your enemy?
Not right away. We will need to study it. It could take years. But it will give us new insight into how the Geth have changed and evolved over the past centuries.
Go ahead. Make a copy.
My people, I owe you a great debt. One I can never repay. The only thing I can offer in return is what you already have. My solemn promise to stay with you until Saren and his Geth armies are defeated.
I never wanted anything more.
Thank you, Shepard.